everybody, this is the Mad Hare himself, and we're about to play an episode here of Slay the Spire. Now, Slay the Spire, if you haven't heard of this game, is a dungeon crawling game where you go up this gigantic spire here in the background, but you do it by building a deck of cards, and that's how you attack and use magic and such. So it's pretty cool how they've kind of woven the deck building mechanic into this game. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. We're going to play Act 1 here, standard. And you get to pick one of three heroes. This guy, who's sort of an attacker, he's a lot about strength. This person, who's more about poisoning your enemies and whittling them down. This person, it's very hard to explain this person. You basically get charges, and the charges is electricity charges, basically lightning charges, and you basically do your attacks from that. I'm gonna go ahead with the Ironclad because I like the Ironclad, and we're just gonna go. Hey, so every time you play this game and die, you come back to the beginning here, and this whale gives you an item, or it gives you the option of doing multiple things here. I'm going to give myself max HP because I feel like max HP is really strong at the beginning in this Act 1. Now, here's the dungeon climb we have to make here. This is the boss here at the top, and all of these things are random events. These things right here are actual fights. This is a merchant. This is something we don't know what it is. Could be anything. And these are elite enemies. The elite enemies are a lot stronger than your normal enemy, but what's cool about them is they drop relics. Relics are these things up here. So my relic that I have from the beginning of the game is Burning Blood. At the end of combat, I heal for 6 HP. That can be really useful because you can mitigate the damage that people deal to you. But anyway, these elite enemies give you relics at the end of their battle. So it's really cool because if you can build up these relics, then maybe you can survive for longer and survive more fights. So since there's an elite enemy here, and that would be cool to go do, double elite enemies. Actually, I'm going to do this left path right here. I'm going to go up this way because I feel like this is the safest path. There's also an elite there we can fight. I'm okay with fighting over only one elite. This path right here is just too many elites. Three elites, that would be too much. Anyway, let's choose this one. Here we go. So you can see our deck here. We have strike cards, defend cards, and bash. Vulnerable basically makes them vulnerable to attack. It's pretty cool. So you get dealt 5 cards and you deal damage or whatnot depending on what you use. So like strike deals 6 damage and defend you gain 5 blocks. So you can block 5 damage. Now this thing over their head right here means he's going to buff himself next turn. So what's cool about this game is you know what your enemies are going to do most of the time. So you know if they're going to attack you or if they're going to buff themselves or debuff you. So what you can do is you can kind of figure out when to use attacks and when to use defenses by looking at your enemies and who to attack, because you might be able to take someone down who's less HP and maybe survive a hit from someone else. So what I'm going to do here, since he's not attacking, is I'm going to apply 2 vulnerable, so it stacks for 2 turns here. So I get 2 turns of vulnerable, and now deal 8 damage. And then I'll deal 1 more strike damage, and then end my turn. Now this right over here is energy. This is how many points of energy you have. Each card has a point value up here at the top left. And the top left point value is how much it costs from your power to use this particular card. All of these are 1, but they can be up to 4, 5, or 6 costs. Since he's going to attack for 6, I'm going to defend twice to give myself 10 block. So now when he attacks me, I won't take any damage. And then I'll strike once. And then we'll end my turn. So you'll notice I have 0 cards here. So what happens that when you have 0 cards is all of these cards get dealt back into your hand and you get dealt the same cards again. So it's kind of cool. So now this is a problem. he's buffed himself, so at the end of each turn, he gains 3 strength. So remember last time his 2 hit was only 6, but now it's 9. Which can be troublesome, but what we're going to do is gain 1 block, take 4 damage, and then Burning Blood will give us back that damage. And we'll apply Vulnerable again. Very nice. Now he's at 12, so I would really like to kill him now, but since I can't, I'll just block the whole turn and end my turn. Let's apply Vulnerable again. And strike, and strike. Ooh, I forgot. Whoops. That was a mistake. Oh well, that's okay. I'll take the damage, but I'll be able to regain the health over time. I'm okay with taking that much damage this early. And let's move on. So I gain back 6 HP, I get gold, and I get to add a card to my deck. I really like this Perfected Strike, because I have a lot of strike cards, so that's actually pretty cool. Let's do that. And we'll do another battle. These guys are pretty easy to kill, Jawworms. You know what? Okay, so he's going to deal 11 damage, so let's defense once and perfect strike once. I'll take some damage here. Only 6 damage, which I can mitigate back if I'm able to kill him. He's about to block and use a buff, so let's just strike, strike, and strike. And then hopefully next turn I'll be able to kill him. If I have 3 strike cards, I'll be able to. Or, actually, this will do fine. Bye-bye. So, more gold, more... Now, Anger is an interesting card. What Anger does is it deals damage, and then it adds a copy of the card to the discard pile. So, every time you use Anger, more angers get stacked in your deck. So it's actually really kind of nice. So let's do that. Question mark. What will it be? It's a merchant. Nice. Unfortunately, I can't buy much. That's an interesting card to have random. Oh, this is actually really nice. 3 weak and vulnerable. So 3 turns of weak and 3 turns of vulnerable. Weak basically means their attacks do less damage, which is really, really nice. So let's grab that. And Pommel Strike, why not? Let's do another battle. These guys are pretty weak. We'll be able to take them out. So, but I do want to... Okay, I know what I'm going to do here. So this can kill this. This and this can kill this. I'll take the 5 damage, and I'll move on. And I'll regain that health back at the end of this turn. There we go, moving on. Ooh, now this is a potion. This goes in my potion slot here. This one, I gain 3 thorns, which I think reflects damage back. Deals when receiving attack damage, deals damage back. And I add another card. Could take another anger. Let's take... let's take anger. Why not? I'm stacking anger this run. This guy has 48 HP. That's a lot of HP. He's going to deal 7 damage. Let's block it out and attack twice. We'll take 2 damage, but that's okay. So he does apply weakness, which means I deal less damage, but... Oh, here's the anger play. Anger, anger. Lots of anger in my deck now. I'm so angry. I could really use some block cards, so let's try to get another card here. I didn't get it. Let's do this, because it'll apply weak. That will only do 9 damage to me, so I'll mitigate that back a bit. I'll still lose a net of three, but... Yep, let's kill him. There we go. Another potion, apply 3 weak, kinda nice. Ooh. I'm gonna just shrug it off because I gain 8 block and I draw a card. That's really nice. Campfire. Okay, now campfires are where you can rest or you can smith, so you can upgrade a card. I'm gonna upgrade a card because I've only hit missing 17 health here. So I'm gonna smith a card. I think I'm going to smith shrug it off, because then I'll gain more block for the one power, which is really a nice trade-off. Let's proceed. Ooh, a strange blue humanoid with a golden helm approaches you with a smile. Hello, friend. I am Cleric. Are you interested in my services? The creature shouts loudly. Oh, sorry, I didn't loudly shout it, but anyway. So I can heal if I pay him 35 gold. Purify, which means I remove a card from my deck. That's nice if you have negative cards in your deck that you've been accumulating because people keep throwing them in your hand. I'm going to heal. Now I'm back at full. I have no gold, but I'm back at full, which is really nice. Oh. See, here's an example of what you would want to take away. Is this parasite, but I'm just gonna stomp on him because I don't want to lose HP right now. Now the spore cloud thing is interesting. So when you kill one of these creatures, it applies vulnerable to you, so that's kind of sucks. But let's do strike on the back one. Anger on the back one. That one's dead. Now I'm vulnerable. Let's defend. And I'll only take 4 damage here. This one's now going to be a problem. Because he's growing. So he's going to deal more damage. See, the 13 is that's a lot of damage. Yeah, the only problem with this character is he doesn't get a lot of defense cards right off the bat, so... I can't kill him. I should mitigate some of this damage, so let's do that. That was a big hit. But now I have some... stuff I can do. I can shrug it off and attack the back one here. Yeah, let's shrug it off so I won't take any damage here. Ooh. Let's do this actually. We'll apply the vulnerable and the weak, and now they're weak forever, which will be really nice. Now they both have strength, so that's a problem, but he's only going to deal 6 damage, so I can mitigate that. Pommel Strike deals 13 damage. I draw 1 card. And Perfected Strike should kill him. Yep, there it goes. Odd Mushroom. Ah, this is a relic. So this is interesting. This is actually not a great one. So when I'm vulnerable, I take 25% more attack damage. Oh no, actually that's really good. That means I'm getting a reduction in damage that I get dealt when I'm vulnerable by 25%. That's actually really good. So, I'm gonna do that. Take that. Well, I don't have any choice. You have to take it, so. I like this Infernal Blade. This seems like an interesting card. Let's use it. Ooh, which treasure chest should I take? Left? Middle, right. Right, because I want to go for the elite here. Bottled Flame. Upon pickup, choose an attack. Start each combat with this card in your hand. Anger. Yes, please. Just so I can start stacking angers. Oh, this guy, I hate this guy. So this guy basically, he'll gain 8 block every turn. So you don't want him to gain block. It's really annoying. But yeah, let's just attack him. He gets confused after he wakes up, so he can't attack this turn. But next turn, look at that. 18. It's not great. Anger. I guess I'll Infernal. Oh, that's nice. It does any attack card. And then I'll defend. And I'll strike one more time and I'll take some damage. Yeah. That's a lot of damage, actually. Ow. I'm gonna pommel strike first. Oh, gain 11 block. And then I'm going to defend again. So I'll only take 2 damage here. Ah, okay, so now he's doing a negative effect, so I can attack him as much as I want here. Let's do this. I like the shockwave here. Now he's vulnerable and weak. Now I'm getting my stuff decreased now, which isn't great. Ooh, that just doesn't cut it. Well, let's use it anyway. Ooh, 6 damage. Strike him. And we're done. Very nice. That's a lot easier than usual. Oh, wow. That's pretty cool. So this relic, if your HP is at or below 50% at the end of combat, you heal 12 HP. That's actually really good. I'm going to disarm. I don't like Warcry. Warcry has its uses, I just don't like it. Let's start the anger stacking here. And kill the one in the back. And defend, and then start killing the sneaky one. These goblins can get annoying because they buff each other and negative buff you, and it's kind of annoying. See, like, he's now giving him damage protections, kind of. Ugh. Okay, this one's dead. Perfected strike to kill the one in the... Oh, wait. Hold on here. If I were to deal 15 damage here, that would make it 7. No, I wouldn't be able to kill him. So let's defense once and pommel strike the back one. Or sorry, perfect strike the back one. Very good. Onward. He only has 14 HP, so Infernal Blade, cleave, strike, strike, and he's dead. Ooh, interesting. Regen potion. This is a... potion, right? Yeah, so it gains 5 regen. That's cool. Clash is interesting. Can only be played if every card in your hand is an attack. So you could defend, or defend, and then use it, and you'll deal 14 damage. So, yeah, it's kind of cool. I'm going to go this way since I'm doing okay on health. Ooh, the poison guys. Well, let's start with Infernal Blade. Let's boomerang. Let's anger. I almost kind of want to use Perfect Strike here and just kill one. No, let's do it. I'll take the 7 damage. Attack, skill. Not the greatest time to get that card. Yep, that's a good turn. I basically mitigated his damage by giving him a strength decrease with that card, the disarm card. And then I defended once, so I got 5. And so he'll deal 5 damage and I'll block it all. It's pretty cool. There we go. And we'll strike him once and strike him twice, and there we go. I don't really care for the ancient potions, so I'm gonna take cleave here because I don't have the card right now that would make Iron Rave really cool, which is basically a card that gives you, it's a power card that applies to you, and it basically makes it so that every time you gain block, you deal damage. So not only would I deal 5 damage for the Iron Wave, I would also deal 3 damage for gaining block. So that, I don't have that card right now, so this card is kind of eh. So I'm gonna deal this. I'm gonna take the cleave. Let's use anger. Let's shock. No, he's actually attacking. Actually, the weak is good. So let's do that for the weak. Defend and take 4 damage here. I'm okay with that. Ooh, everything's an attack. You know what that means? Clash. Very nice. Anger. Well, we can just kill him, right? Strike and strike. Yeah, he's dead. Cool. Add another card. Now, I like this card, the offering card. I just don't like losing the 6 HP. I'd rather take the uppercut. Especially for Act 1. I think in higher acts it might be cool to have that other card, but... Okay, now this guy can be annoying. This guy, what he does is... When he steals gold from you every time he attacks, but then he'll run away, just like other looter type people from other games. So really, you just have to take him down as quick as possible. There goes my gold. So really, if it would be possible, yeah, let's defend twice here and then clash and then pommel strike and he's dead. Cool. I got my gold back. I don't care about the skill potion. I know it's good, but I like these right now. Carnage is nice because it's a very weird card. So ethereal, this skill right here means that if it's in your hand, you have to use it, because if you don't use it, it gets burned immediately and it can't use it again. It becomes unplayable. It's exhausted. I like it. Let's take it. Campfire before the boss. Let's rest this time because I don't have a lot of HP, and it's time for the boss. Now this guy is pretty interesting. He has 140 health. Once you half his health, once you get him below 70 or 60, he'll split into two slimes that have the exact same HP. So he'll split into two slimes with 60 HP, for example, and then those slimes will again break apart. So it's kind of annoying, but we'll deal with it. Let's steal as much damage as possible this first turn, because he's not attacking. Okay, so he's added slimed cards into my deck. So basically those can come up, and it means I have less attacks to do. So we don't know what he's doing here. But, well, I mean, we know what he's doing. He's charging up an attack, but... we're going to deal 9 damage and draw a card, and then we're going to deal 20 damage, trying to get him close to that cutoff. Because he'll do, I think, 35 damage now. Yeah, 35 damage next turn, which is like, no. Let's use Infernal Blade. Let's use Clash. Haha, he's been interrupted. This means he is splitting next turn. Well, Anger. Deal 2 damage 4 times. Okay, deal 2 damage 4 times. And we'll bash to add the vulnerable, because I think that vulnerable will split. Which would be nice. Nope, it doesn't. Okay, that's fine. 43 is not bad to have, but the problem is, look at these attack values. We're gonna apply the 3 weak and vulnerable to all, so that value goes down a bit. And then I guess I don't really want to take 24 damage, which is a lot of damage, so I'll defend once here. I'll take 7 from the front and 12 from the back.
Ugh.
I'll get some cards back here. I'll anger again. And then I will defend once, defend twice, and continue to strike. I hate slime so much. Anger the guy in the back. We will perfect strike this guy. Now he's dead. And we can't use carnage, it'll get etherealed off, but that's okay. I'll cleave. And we'll continue on this merry-go-round. I've gotten uppercut. I've gotten disarm. I'm gonna upper. So see, look, so there's 2 slimed in here. Now I can burn an energy in order to get rid of slimed. But that's an energy I have to burn in order to get rid of it. So I'll just keep it in my hand. And he's gonna split anyway. Actually, I'll get rid of one of the slimed right now. So it's burned, it goes here, see, it's right here. So that's kinda cool. 2 little slimes. You know what? That's not enough damage. 1, 2, 3, and then clash. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna defend once. I'm gonna get rid of the slime. And then I'm gonna clash on the front one, and then I'm gonna strike the front one. Now the front one's dead. I'll take 2 damage here. Very nice. I get another slimed. I'll anger, and I will strike. And he's dead. And we've done it. We are done with the first... with the first act here. Oh, that's very nice. I like that. Deal 4 damage to all enemies. Heal HP equal to unblocked damage. So if you deal 16 damage, you'll take 16 health back. That's pretty cool. So, at the end of each boss battle, you get this big, gigantic, slimy chest, which is a glowy-glowy, ne? It's glowy-glowy. You open it, and you get to choose a relic. Now, this is pretty cool. This tail means that if I choose this, I'll get to revive once. This one, I gain 3 curses and 3 relics. Nah. This one, whenever you lose HP, draw 1 card. Eh, not so great. Let's get the lizard tail. So, and then after you press proceed here, you get to see Act 2. Look at it, it's all beautiful and wonderful. And then look, it's all going back up to the top where this 2 flame thing is here. Let me tell you, that boss is not fun. But anyway, guys, I'm going to leave it here. It's been a great video, and I hope you had fun with Slay the Spire. I know I'm kind of coming to Slay the Spire late, but, you know, I'm hoping y'all enjoyed it. If you liked my video, leave me a comment below, or if you liked it a lot, give me a thumbs up, and if you really, really, really liked it, then hit subscribe, and you'll see more in the days to come. So please, thank you again for joining us, and see you later. Bye now.